The SIM card registration process was initially meant to go hand in hand with the switch off of counterfeit mobile handsets to fulfill the objective of fighting mobile propagated crimes like kidnappings, fraud and hate messages. But the SIM card switch off was shelved to allow for the completion of the necessary laws to enable the operators implement the move. CCK Director General says mobile network operators are now prepared to complete the process.
Our projection is that we should have all SIM cards registered before the end of December.
2 years ago, the commission had embarked on the registration, but it was unsuccessful since there was no law that compelled operators to switch off unregistered customers. In fact, the commission will go to all lengths to ensure that all those who intend to register do so, including the use of modern technology in registering the SIM cards.
If we come to find that they are okay for us to use, then I think it will be a much easier exercise because somebody would be able to register their SIM card from wherever they are.
Once implemented, CCK will now be able to monitor hate messages, especially as the country heads to the general elections. Meanwhile, the more than 735,000 shareholders of leading mobile service provider Safaricom may shoulder the burden of the government's 10% excise duty slapped on money transfer services like M-Pesa on Friday. Safaricom Chief Executive Bob Collymore has told KIS TV that the additional tax burden will be shouldered by either the customer or the shareholders, who include the government, which has a 35% stake. That could mean that the over 700,000 shareholders of Safaricom may get reduced dividends or none if the minister's proposals sail through in parliament. For News at 8, I'm Joanne Gakara.